anybody just by being on this earth, you know that the risk of a heart attack is higher than the risk of anything else after a certain age. So you, everyone needs to be aware, everyone needs to follow good procedures. Then there are special people, like if you are born in a family where somebody has had a heart attack in their 40s and 50s, we consider those high-risk families. If you were a smoker as a young person, that thing has produced some changes in your coronary arteries and therefore you might be at higher risk. If you were born with high cholesterol, of course, or if you're blood pressure is not very good. Those are all things that modify risk from a normal person to a much higher risk. So what you need to know is the basic investigations include going to a doctor or to a wellness center that is able to tell you what's in the body that is not as healthy as you think, and maybe there is already a signal with cholesterol, already a signal with sugar, already a signal with triglycerides, already a signal with blood pressure, and these are all things that you need to intervene on early, when you are healthy, young, and strong. Controlling cholesterol has a lot of power, controlling sugar has a lot of power, controlling blood pressure has a lot of power, controlling triglycerides has a lot of power. Those are all things that you have to do with the help of an expert center, and this can be either at the doctor's office or, better yet, in a wellness center like the BWC. There are two ways to investigate your risk of a heart attack. If you are younger than 45 years old, then it's mostly a conversation with an expert, and it's an evaluation of blood tests, and it can be a genetic testing. If you're older than 45, we can actually look at whether you are building plaques in the coronary arteries or in the carotid arteries. So we have ultrasound-based tests to look at whether your carotid arteries are still clean or have already started to build the plaque that can give you a stroke. We can do the same with an X-ray, a CT of the chest to look at whether the coronary arteries have plaques, and those plaques can obstruct the flow of blood, and that is the cause of a heart attack. So for people who are older than 45, really you cannot rely on the mirror. The mirror is not a good way to know if you're healthy. You can feel great, you can look great, but you may have inside you what will drive the an early heart attack, which is actually a cause for death in many cases. So it's an inexpensive test. It's something that everybody should do at least once after the age of 45. Look at the coronary arteries and see if they are clean. A clean artery, no heart attack. An artery that is not clean, you are at high risk of a heart attack. You still can live a long life if you do everything right. And that's the power of testing. You test not to discover bad news against which you can't do anything. You do it to find action items. There is always an opportunity to modify your risk. Even if you discover some plaques in your coronary arteries, by doing the right thing, you will protect your heart and you will live a long life.